Things have really been heating up of late for pioneering tech, the fire prevention technology specialist. They've inked a number of exciting deals, as well as joined forces with a leading fire prevention firm in Europe. With me on the line now is President and CEO Kevin Callahan. Kevin, good to speak to you.
Thank you very much for having me.
Kevin, importantly, first of all, to stress, you're about technology and innovation, aren't you, not marketing?
Yes, we are a technology company. We commercialize and manufacture products specifically in the cooking fire prevention space, and then distribute those products through major sales channel partners.
Well, look, some staggering numbers here. 35% increase in sales on the same period a year earlier, 201% increase in net income. How's the fourth quarter shaped up, Kevin?
Yeah, things look great. Year over year, we were up about 55%. We're profitable again. EBITDA is strong. Net income is just a little over $1 million.
Where do you see future growth for you?
Well, we expect this growth to continue. Some of what's driving that growth is one of our products, SmartBurner, which represents about 70% of our sales at present. And as awareness grows for that product, as do sales, but a couple of developments just over the past year, that sort of shift from us selling our products directly to that of working with three of the largest supply channel distributors in North America have meant that we now have 500 or 600 people actively selling our products into the channels that we want to be in. Versus the 5 or 6 we had a year and a half ago.
Might sound a bit of a silly question, but how much of a problem are cooking-related fires? I mean, what's the market like for your smart burner cooking system?
Cooking fires are the number one cause of household fire, not just in North America, but around the world. But just as an example, in the U.S., cooking is responsible for almost 50% or 48% of all household fires. So that equates to about 170,000 reported fires every year. And for every fire that's reported in the U.S., there are another 30 that aren't. So 4 to 5 million times a year, people set fire on their cooktop. It's a multi-billion dollar problem in the U.S. People die, thousands are injured. So it's a significant problem.
Tell me a little bit about your other product here, the safety sensor. I know you had a good response when you introduced them at Ohio University earlier.
Oh, yeah, safety sensor is a great product. It was designed for the microwave oven. And it's not so much that it was designed to prevent cooking fires. It was actually, although it does, what it does is it prevents microwave false alarms. And you may not think that's a big problem, but imagine a university where a kid, virtually every kid, freshman in their dorm room, have a microwave oven. And very few of these kids know how to cook, so they may come home, throw some popcorn in, hit 20 minutes instead of 2 minutes. And it's not that a fire starts, but it smokes like crazy, and that activates the fire alarm. When the fire alarm is activated, the building has to evacuate. And the second or third time that happens in the middle of the winter, in the middle of the night, kids just roll over and say somebody's burnt some popcorn and they don't get out of bed. So if there is a fire, then people could die. But also importantly, it cost the school a great deal of money. So the test we did with Ohio University was, we worked with their fire department on campus. They had 400 runs per year to the campus that were false alarms. 300 of those were related to a microwave oven. So we worked with them and with FEMA, who funded the installation of 5,000 of these safety sensor units, which basically are like small smoke detectors that attach to the microwave and interrupt power to the microwave at the first sign of smoke. In any event, the pretest, so 400 runs to the school that cost them $2,000 per run. After being installed for 1 year, they did a post-test and we reduced the number of microwave runs by 92%. So the product had a quick return on investment and had a significant impact for them financially. So this product is relevant anywhere where an evacuation creates a dangerous situation, like a senior's facility or a hospital, or a loss of productivity in like an office tower, or significant costs like this example at Ohio University.
Well, I know North America has been a big focus for you, but also you've teamed up with a fire prevention firm in Europe.
Well, we would like to expand to other markets, and we met a great company called Inahome, who are based in Finland. And they've had some success with a different product over there in Europe. So we've met with them, and the way the agreement is proposed to work is we'll distribute some of their products through our channels over here in a complementary fashion, and they would do the same for us and our products over in Europe and other parts or other countries overseas.
Well, Kevin, it's certainly been a busy period for you. What's the focus going forward?
Much of the same. I talked about the three supply partners that we have in North America. Well, we're just getting started with them, so we're expecting great things from them in the coming year. So we're anticipating the same kind of growth that we experienced in 2016. There's also been, with our SmartBurner and Safety Element product, a bit of a disruption in the industry, that being that going forward, as of later in 2018, no appliance manufacturer will be able to sell an electric coil stove in North America that doesn't include cooking fire prevention technology. Now, we've driven that, and I think that that's going to have a substantial impact for us in the years to come, just based on the awareness it will create and the opportunities it will create in both Canada and the United States.
Very good, Kevin. Look, just one final question. What about competition? Are there many others out there doing what you're doing?
At present, no. We don't have any real competition. Our only competition would be people who alert you to the fact that you already have a fire or may suppress a fire, i.e. extinguish it. So, no, at present, no real competition, although I can tell you we would welcome it. Just on the electric coil aftermarket side of the business, probably worth about $4 or $5 billion in North America. We've had to do all the heavy lifting, so I think as awareness increases, there will be more people in this space, and we would welcome that competition.
Certainly a bright future ahead, Kevin. Good to speak to you. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you very much for having me. All the best.